And I'm gonna show you with proof. I have proof. So let me get my stuff ready and you're gonna see it pop up on the screen too. What's up, welcome back to my channel. I am Diana, creator of Money Boss Mama. And in this video, I'm gonna be sharing with you guys some tips to help you hashtag go get that job, sis. So if you are trying to get a job at a new company or you're trying to promote at your current company, I've got you. After being rejected over 10 times, and working alongside an HR recruiter, I have learned quite a few tips that I did not know before that really, really helped me to land my first two big girl jobs. So let's go ahead and get into them. Okay, I know for many of us, including me, we have a bad habit of looking at a job posting, skimming through it, going straight to the requirements, making sure we meet the minimum requirements, clicking apply, and then hoping for the best. Stop doing this. The minimum requirements may not list everything that you need to know to be able to carry out the job function successfully. And then you may get in the interview and then get hit with a question that you have absolutely no answer for. And that is the worst heart and ass moment when you know you have no answer, but you're repeating back their question to give yourself enough time to think of an answer, but you don't have no answer. Or maybe you get the job and realize certain things are part of your job description and you don't really like those things. But your job description, reading it in its entirety, is going to give you a better feel of what is expected of you in that role and what your day-to-day is going to look like. And you can use this to your advantage in regards to helping you make practice questions, which we will be discussing here shortly. This is really important and it's going to help you in regards to getting you prepared for the job interview. As you are receiving recognition at work, you want to make sure to document these things. I kept mine in a Word document, and every time I received recognition, maybe I got an award, I successfully completed a project, or I made an innovative improvement, I would document these things and I just kept an ongoing Word document. All right, guys, I just did some digging to find this document. This is just the first copy, but I have it marked as star stories for these like wow stories that I was adding to every time they happened. And I also put down what I've done to actually improve my skills. And really quickly, another tip in regards to the star format that I may or may not have discussed it in this part of the video yet. But whenever I wrote down the story, I automatically put it in the star mat so I knew, you know, how I would actually word it in the interview.
Writing down all of your accomplishments and how you've actually utilized your skills, you're jogging your memory. And this way, whenever you are in the middle of an interview and they ask you a question that requires you to detail out how you've utilized the skills that you've put in your resume, you can pull from these things. You're not drawing a blank, which is like the worst feeling ever when you know you don't have an answer. And this way, whenever you have everything listed out, you can easily pull the things that you want to highlight from the things that maybe don't pertain to the job position. This list is also going to help you when you're making potential practice questions. If you can't think of many questions, maybe the job description is not very helpful in helping you to create these practice questions, you can just write down stories that you feel like would really highlight the skills that they are looking for. And for an example, I had a job interview in which I did not have a lot to go off of in regards to creating practice questions. So on this Word document, I also listed like these wow stories, stories with the wow factor. And I made an innovative improvement. So at that time, I worked in customer service, and our members, we had an app for them so they could go in and look at their claims. And I made an innovative improvement that was sent up as a suggestion and actually got approved. And that helped to cut down on call volume, which help to cut down on costs. So I put this story in there and other stories like this. So whenever I got asked a question and I didn't really have that question part of my practice questions, I could pull from that story and I kind of molded it to fit the question that they were asking me. And if you're wondering what kind of stories you should write down, you want to write down stories in which you gave exceptional customer service. Maybe you had an irate, difficult customer, and by the end of the interaction, they left happy and satisfied. You learned a new skill, you were on a project team or led a successful project team, maybe you made an innovative improvement, certain things like that that are really going to help them see that you are the right fit for the job. This is the golden tip. Make practice questions. After you've read the entire job posting, you should have a pretty good idea of some potential questions that the interviewer might ask you. You do not have to wait until you know that you've gotten an interview. You can actually start the second you click submit. That way you have enough time to really go through and answer each potential question and make sure you fine-tune your answers. I did this for both of my big interviews, and I know for a fact, this is what truly helped me stand out and get the job. Every question they asked me, I had in my potential question packet. I had a packet of potential questions that they might ask me, as well as my stories and my wow stories. And I actually went through and made an example of how I utilize each skill. And so every time they asked me a question, even though I was nervous as hell, I literally had tissues under each armpit. They didn't know that.
I want to show you guys my interview practice questions that I made. This was for one interview and this was for the other, and I kind of could use some of the same questions for the other interview. But this is what I used to study before each interview. It's literally like a study sheet, and you can see here, I'll show you a few examples of mine. Like, what is your experience in da 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 da, and this is exactly what it was that I was going to be doing. Tell me about yourself. You guys can, I highly recommend that you include this in your practice questions. Tell me about yourself. This is the time for you to truly sell yourself. And so, of course, obviously, you want to structure your answer to highlight all of the requirements and skills or the ones that you have experience in for the job you are applying for. And why did you apply for this job? I find that these two questions are often asked, so make sure you include this. But here's an example of one of mine. Please share with me an example of how you helped coach or mentor someone, because this was actually in the job description. And what improvements did you see in the person's knowledge or skills? Because this was part of the job description too, so I just molded it to fit that job description or duty that they had. And also, gathering information from multiple sources was one of the was listed in the job description. So I just said, share an example of a time you had to gather information from multiple sources. How did you determine which information was relevant?
I answered each question with confidence because I had that time to recite my answers and practice them and make sure that I had them down. So to do this, you want to print out the job posting. Print out the job posting and grab a highlighter, and you're gonna go through and highlight each requirement. Every single requirement, you want to highlight every single one of those. And then you wanna go down to the actual job description where they're describing the job. It may say duties or like responsibilities. And you wanna highlight each one that you feel like you are going to need to prove that you have the qualifications for. And I have an example here on the screen. I found a job posting. This is for USPS, a distribution associate. So let's use number 3 as an example. It says, provides product and service information to customers, including informing customers regarding special offers,
selling related merchandise, and promoting products based on customer needs. So a potential practice question could be, tell me about a time in which a customer came in wanting a product you did not carry, but you upsold the products that you did have in stock, and that led to the closing, the successful closing of a sale. Just literally off the top of my head. If you've ever been in an interview, you know that it's quite possible that they will ask you a question like that based on a responsibility like this. And so you can have different variations of the practice questions, but that's just a general idea of how you could go about it. And in regards to the requirements that you highlighted, hopefully you will highlight all of them. You want to turn all of them into potential practice questions. So you can choose which ones that you feel like would be most important, but I recommend making all of them practice questions because they're really going to focus in on the actual requirements that are a part of the job posting. And when you're done, you want to go through and edit your answers just to clean them up and make them more precise. And guys, as a side note, do not be afraid to talk about a time in which the outcome was not desirable. I did this in both of my interviews, and I think that this took them by surprise, but in a really good way, because in interviews they are so used to hearing about people's positive outcomes. So to hear about an outcome in which it was not positive really took them back, and you want to make sure that you are highlighting what you learned from that situation. Employers love hearing about that and what you could have done differently next time, or would do differently next time. This was a tip that I got from the HR recruiter, and it worked like a charm because this was part of their feedback from my interview. The goal of each company is to hire the right person. They want to hire the person that they feel like would be a good fit for the company and would be most successful in the job role. So your interview is like a test drive. This is your time to shine. This is your time to brag on yourself. And I know, like, as women, it's really hard for us to do that. It feels wrong. It feels dirty to brag on ourselves. We want to be super humble. Like if someone says, girl, you look good today, we're like, oh, this shirt, I've had this shirt for da-da-da-da-da. Don't do that. Do not come into your interview with that energy. We need bad girl energy. Like, we know we got this job, walking in with your chest poked out with confidence, because they're looking for that girl. And you are that girl. But anyway, you want to make sure you leave a lasting impact after you answer each question. That is going to make those in that interview remember who you are. You want to be memorable because you are not the only person that's going to be interviewing for this job. Remember that you want your answers to be as thorough as possible, talking about what you did and what the end result of your efforts were. I learned from an HR rep that if they ask you immediately after you answer a question, additional questions, it's probably safe to say that you were not as thorough as you could have been. But contrarily, they don't want to listen to you ramble either. So it's kind of like Goldilocks, not too much, not too little, just right. And I find that using the STAR technique helps to ensure that you're giving enough detail, but not so much to where it's overwhelming, and it makes your answers very thorough and memorable. And going through the acronym, S is for situation. This is when you are describing the who, what, when, where, and how. T is for task. You are describing your responsibility in regards to the situation you are discussing. What was it that you were tasked to do? A is for action. What steps did you take? And R is for result. This is wrapping up your answer in a nice little bow when you're describing the outcome of what your efforts were. If you are anything like me, whenever you get super nervous, you tend to stumble over your words. You maybe mush your words together. But I find that whenever you actually read your answers out loud,
it helps you to build up that confidence you need to speak with ease. And it also helps you to kind of fine tune your voice inflection, as well as help to make your answers stick. And to take it up a notch, I do recommend recording yourself as you are saying your answers to your practice questions. I know our voices tend to make us cringe, but I swear by this technique. You also want to pretend that your recording device, so whatever it is that you are using to record, is the actual interviewer. So you want to make sure that you maintain eye contact. So whatever it is you are using to record, maintain eye contact with that device. And this way you can go back and compare different recordings to measure your progress, as well as critique yourself. Like, make sure that the way that you are sitting, your posture is good. I did this before my first two big interviews, and it worked like a charm because I noticed that I needed to tweak my tone to sound more enthusiastic and that I was not maintaining eye contact. This is obviously going to depend on the type of work that you are applying for, but if applicable, I always recommend bringing a portfolio of your work. Even if you feel like you're being extra, because I felt like I was being extra, you're probably not, and that's really going to add on the points and help them remember who you are. I was actually told both times I brought my portfolio to an interview, I was the only applicant who actually presented copies of my work. And it shows that you just really took the time to prepare. You're taking this thing seriously because you're willing to prove through copies of your work that you have the skills to back up, you know, whatever it is that your resume says that you can do. And it doesn't have to be super expensive. You guys can use a binder, you can use a nice folder. They even have websites now that allow you to build your portfolio online. Now, if it's a face-to-face interview, I recommend bringing something that they can have in their hands. But I went all out because I really wanted to get these jobs. For both portfolios, I bought black binders from Walmart that were like $10 to $12, and I placed copies of my best work as well as a printed copy of my resume and put them into those little clear sleeves just for extra protection. All right, this is the most important tip in my opinion, and it is to visualize yourself in that position and claim it. Claim it like it is yours. When you start to see yourself actually doing what you desire, you start to manifest those things into your life because you're believing in it, which means that you're taking action. You're taking the necessary steps to attain that reality. And even in the midst of all my rejections, I still stood firm in my belief. I still stood behind myself. I had my back. And I continued to work towards actually getting a promotion and out of my current job role because I believed in it so much. Like, literally, I was depressed in my job role. And I remember I had this duplex that I have now, and I had my desk out in my living room, and I had just gotten off a call because I was a CSR. And I said, I'm a technical writer. I claimed that. I said, I'm a technical writer. I really believed it. Now, I thought I was delusional, not gonna lie, but I was like, I am a technical writer, and there was nothing anyone could say to me that was gonna make me believe any different because I had claimed that this was my dream job, y'all. I had claimed it and I was going to get it. I visualized myself in my at my desk, in my little blazer. I could clearly see myself in this role. So whatever necessary steps that I needed to take to get this role, I was willing to do it. And I'm gonna show you with proof. I have proof. So let me get my stuff ready, and you're gonna see it pop up on the screen too. So this is all in 2018, okay? So July 12th, this is after I withdrew my first application for this position because I didn't have any confidence in myself. I was like, I don't have the skills for this position. So I withdrew my application. But after I took some time to prepare for this job role, doing the tips that I gave you guys and that the HR rep gave me, I reapplied for the position. nothing I had ever done would make me qualify for this position. But I said, you know what? I can see myself doing it. This is my dream job. I'm going to go after it. And on July 18th, so 6 days later, I wrote out an I got the job announcement in my apps. I opened the Notes apps in my phone, Notes app, and I started typing out my announcement that I was going to put on my Facebook page. Mind you, I didn't even know if I got the interview yet. It was possible that the status was going to change to applicant not selected, like all of my others did, but it was just something about having that fire in my spirit and knowing that it was mine and claiming that it was mine and willing to do whatever to get this job position that led me to believe, like, I'm going to get it. So I wrote out my Facebook status, I got the job announcement to myself that you see here, and you'll see the date, July 18th. August 10th was my interview date. So mind you, a month earlier, I said that I got the job, even though I didn't have the job, but I wrote it so that I could continue to read it and really believe it. And August 13th, I actually got an offer and I accepted. And crazy thing is, for my current job position, I'll put it up on the screen too. For my current job position, I did the same exact thing. So the day before my interview, I actually wrote out my status because the dream job turned into the job from hell, and sis was ready to go. And so I typed it out and I took it up a notch. So I even said that I wanted a window seat because where I was, we were moved 3 times in the department. And I was in a little dark cubicle and I slowly felt like I was losing my soul. The job was just sucking the life out of me. And I put that I wanted to sit by the window because I really wanted a window seat because the weather just affects my mood. And I remember after the interview, I was nervous because I didn't know if I did well or not. I was kind of being down on myself, but they called me like 30 minutes later and said that I got the job. And I did all the tips that I did with the first interview. I got the job. And when I got there, guess where I sat? They said that they held the window seat for the new worker, which was me. I got the window seat, and it was a big window. It was windows all around. And basically, moral of the story is you can only go as far as your mind allows you to. Who sets our limitations? Us. We set our limitations. We say that we want something, but then we tell ourselves that we can't have it at the same time. And so we're like living in this constant state of conflict where we really want something, but simultaneously, we also tell ourselves that we can't have it. And it's like, which side are you going to believe in? You know? So I really hope that these tips helped you guys out. And if you have any additional tips, leave them down below. I will catch you guys in the next one.
Good morning. Today is my last official day, well, full day in the current position that I'm in. And on my way to work, I was thinking about how miserable I would have been if I did not get the courage to apply out elsewhere because I was afraid of what my manager would say if I would make him upset, yada yada. But I am super excited. I feel like I am being released from jail. But that led me to ask myself this question. Why not me?